for a step or anything. Too short to use for the deck, but my handy dandy goose pattern. Laid it up there. Perfect. So, this is the cleaner side to draw on. Mark the eye hole. Alright, I can see that.
Hang this pattern back up.
Saw, just, it's nice because the back of the bird slants where I can get at this, so. Okay, thought that was, I was getting ready to badmouth the blade, and I realized I put it on upside down. Great. Alright, that was on me for not checking it. The blades, the pointy part should point down, because it rotates down, holds the board down to the table. So, that's on me for not checking that. Something about having a camera pointed at you when you're trying to work is a little bit distracting. So here we go again. Let's see. I think you'll notice a difference in the sound. Oh yeah. That's better. I'm cutting a little bit outside the line. Save the line a bit there. Then I'll have something to work to with the sandpaper. Alright, that's right there. That makes it easier. Surprised that the blade hasn't broken. So there it is. There's the blade. It's I gotta turn my AC back on. It's killing me in here. I think it's 94 degrees outside, which is very unusual for Virginia to get above 90. I think it's been 90 for for 20 days straight, over 90, which is some huge crazy record. All right, the next thing to do is to drill the hole. Well, I'm going to cut the dowel. Cut the dowel as long as I'm running the table saw. Cut the dowel. Marking the dowel from the drawing. Just going to mark it off. It's not, the dowel isn't that critical. Make it a little oversized. I marked it right there. Then I'll just zip it on the table saw here. So now I'm gonna drill the hole 7/8. 3/4 was a bit too small. 1 inch was too big. So 7/8 for that. And that's the one problem you run into when you're using scrap is unusual sizes. You don't know what the size is, but if you have a lathe, you can. Now I turned part of this one down to 3/4 for another Whirligig, so I just turned it down. So you have some, you chuck your piece up in the drill press and just sand it down to the diameter you need. And you only needed that diameter to go through the hole. You can have it go up against the stop in the middle. Doesn't matter if one's, you know, a 1/16 of an inch and diameter larger on one side than the other. It doesn't matter. Unless you're a perfectionist. Which, with Whirligigs, you know, you don't have to be a perfectionist. So anyway, let's go ahead. I'm going to go ahead and drill through the body of the beast here. Okay, I've got my hole drilled for the cross piece. The wing axle. The drill press is set up with the spade bit. You don't have to have all this equipment for sure. You can do this with a hand drill. I like to use the drill press because it gets it square, gets the hole, and thus the cross piece exactly square to the bird, makes it fly better. One thing I will say on these spade bits, when you go through and it breaks out the other side, especially if you're using plywood, it'll splinter it all out. So I use a backup piece, right? Like a sacrificial bite. This is going to get a hole in it partially, but it'll help it prevent the splintering of the body itself, of the good stuff that we want. That'll help. All right, so let's go ahead and drill this. I got my safety glasses on. Yes. Success. All right, see if it works. It's a little small. May have to take this over to the lathe and just sand it down a little bit, or it might have a little edge on it. That'll work. So there we go on the on the body. That's where we are on the body so far. That's good. Next step is to cut out the wing pattern. I need 4. Out here in the other garage where I have my dad's old 10-inch cable drive table saw. Anyway. Try to find a nice clear piece of 2x4 and cut this up into 4 blades. I'm going to use the table saw to rip it. Not sure I'm really liking this piece. It's got some knots in it. So let me see if I can find another piece. Okay, so we know there's 2x4. There's the pattern for the wing. And so you got plenty of room to make that happen. Only trouble is this one has knots all in it. I'm gonna try to find one that doesn't have so many knots. I've got a piece to the proper thickness already cut out, and I'm going to use this as a guide in here, and I will cut it a little bigger than the guide because I'm going to plane these down. Bought a used planer off my neighbor when he was moving out. Didn't want to haul it all the way to the new place across the country. So okay, let's see what that does. Probably ought to do a test cut.
Thank you.
one. That's pretty good. I can do some more sanding on this after I get them glued up. So there's the wing.